It don't take much strength to pull a trigger, but try and get up every morning, day after day, and work for a living. Let's see him try that. Then we'll see who's the real tough guy. The working man is the tough guy. So hard, fuckers wanna find me.
Watching the throne, don't let me get in my zone. Don't let me get in my zone. Don't let me get in my zone. These other niggas is lying, acting like the summer ain't mine.
I got that hot to my home.
You know how many hot bitches I own. Don't let me get in my zone. 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 The stars is in the building, they hands to the ceiling. I know I'm about to kill it. How you know I got that feeling? You are now watching the throne. Don't let me into my zone. Don't let me into my zone. I'm definitely in my zone.
And welcome to the 17th season of InBounds with the Raiders. I am Toni Esther, and today I'm here with David Ausberry. A little bit about David. He was a top wide receiver prospect coming out of Lemoore High School here in California. After high school, he attended USC, and in 2011, he was drafted by the Oakland Raiders, where he currently plays as a tight end and on special teams. Could you tell us what your role is on the field as a tight end and on special teams?
Hey Toni, how you doing first of all? But you know, as a tight end, we do a lot of, you know, we do a lot of the dirty work, blocking, receiving, and pretty much whenever anything is needed, the tight ends are called upon. And then on special teams, you pretty much, if you're not a starter, you're on every special team, just, you know, trying to give everybody a boost of energy and trying to make a play. And that's what it's about.
Hey, sounds very important.
Very important.
So going back to your high school years, could you describe your normal routine during football season?
Well, a normal routine in football season would be waking up around 6 o'clock, working out in the morning, you know, going through all the classes up until 3 o'clock, you know, and of course after school practice. You know, after that, you know, if you want it to be good, you know, you can get with your teammates and coaches, watch a little film and try to get a feel for what's going on, you know, similar to what we do now, but not, you know, obviously not as detailed, but you know, that's what we did in high school. We had a lot of preparation, just trying to get a head start on the next opponent.
Very good. And did you play any other sports in high school other than football?
I did. I played basketball and I ran track.
So during basketball season, yeah. Track season, did you have the same kind of time management? Was it a little different?
It was a little bit different schedule, just, you know, the seasons. And, you know, in the winter, it's about 25, 30 degrees. So we wasn't out there working out or anything like that. But basketball is pretty much, it is more about maintaining your body. You know, a lot of cardio and preparation, you know, a lot of practice and just trying to always keep an edge on the ball.
Great. So it sounds like you worked hard during school.
Very hard.
Nice. So then comes your senior year, and I'm sure you had multiple offers for football to go to different schools. How did you finally decide that USC was the school for you?
Well, you know, I went ahead and took my recruiting trips. I didn't take all five. I went to Nebraska, Ohio State, University of Georgia, and USC. And really, it came down to where I felt comfortable and where I felt like I had a better chance to be, you know, successful. I felt like I would have had a chance to go to the league out of any school I went to, but just USC at the time, you know, we're coming off of, you know, two back-to-back championships. Pete Carroll, all the guys are in the league. I'm playing with a few of them now. And you just really couldn't beat the Southern California scene, and the school is great, so that was just my choice.
Yeah, it's a good football school. Yeah. I don't know about as good as LSU, but it's a good one. For our student athletes who are watching this, when looking at different schools and trying to decide, what are some key factors that you could tell these students to look for when deciding what school to go to?
Definitely if they have, you know, the major that you're interested in, and, you know, don't seclude yourself just to one thing, you know, like, you know, explore everything, explore all the options, because you never know what you're going to like and what you may begin to love. So I would say advice is, you know, take the time, you know, to get in touch with whoever wants to help you out, and, you know, take advantage of the opportunities, because a lot of people don't get to go to college. So you know, just get comfortable in, you know, what you want to do and have fun. You know, it's the best time of your life.
Great. So then once you got to USC and you got to the feel of how everything went, did you have to adjust your time management skills from high school to being at a collegiate level?
Definitely. A lot of people won't admit it, but, you know, coming out of high school, you know, you got your mom, you probably got another sibling around the house that's trying to, you know, helping you out, keeping you organized. When you get to college, it's you and a few of your other buddies, a few other teammates that you live with, trying to keep it together. So it can get hectic at times. But you gotta keep running. You gotta keep focusing. You know, keep a common goal in mind that you want to graduate first off, and you know the success will come afterwards. And whatever it is, either it's sports or academic. So you just gotta try to stay focused and you know, you use the resources, you know, use your tutors, use your counselor and advisors. They, you know, they're there to help you, and you know, they'll do a great job at it.
Yeah, that's definitely a blessing to have those counselors and tutors and everything. So academics is important to you. Has it always been important to you?
I'm not gonna lie, you know, I didn't, you know, growing up, I didn't know I was gonna have a chance to, you know, go to college. But once I got to my senior year in high school, or my junior year, you know, I was getting some big offers. So I mean, I knew I had to. I was already eligible, but I just wanted to, you know, push myself to see where I can get. I ended up graduating with a 3.5, and pretty much had a chance to go wherever I wanted. But you know, it's something that has to be put into your mind early. You can't just turn the switch on and turn it off when you want. It's something that you really want to do. You got to go out there and put the effort into it, and keep your grades up just to, you know, have people pay attention to you. So I think it's very important to, you know, pay attention to your grades and just try to, you know, try to keep pushing, because, you know, to pass up a chance to go to college would be, that's not a smart decision.
Yeah, college is definitely a good place to go, and a 3.5, congratulations on that. That's a big accomplishment, very big. So now going back to your NFL career, in the off season, do you remain active? Do you still work out when you're not required to?
Definitely. Just like I said, it's one of those things, as a competitor, you want to always have an edge. So it's small things like, you know, going into the gym and just getting on the treadmill for a few minutes, or getting a few curls in or some push-ups, just little things like that. But it's mainly just, you know, trying to keep an edge on the opponent, and just always trying to stay ahead of the game.
Right. So then what about your diet? Do you have a specific diet you're trying to follow? Do you eliminate certain foods?
Well, right now, you know, just... I'm not gonna lie, I'm not really the picky eater, but you know, if you wanna have, you know, optimum performance, you wanna eat healthy, you wanna eat your fruits and vegetables and a lot of water. That's the most important thing, because you do run a lot, and now, you know, we're at a condensed roster, so you take a lot of reps, so you definitely have to be hydrated, and you know, can take care of your body. It's what makes your money, so you just gotta really take care of your body.
Right, and so for our students at home who might not be athletes, could you maybe tell them the importance of physical activity, and should we encourage them to be active? Like, for example, the NFL plays 60. Is that something that you are involved with or know about?
I haven't had the opportunity to get into it yet, but I'd like to at some point. But it's very important. Like, you don't ever want to be that kid sitting at home playing video games all day. You know, get out and enjoy the sun. And it really doesn't have to be a strenuous activity. It can be something as small as, you know, taking a 15-minute walk around the block. You know, it's nothing really too serious, but it's just very important. It puts more years onto your life when you exercise. So taking into account is very important.
Yes, physical activity is very important. So before we go, I just want to ask you, did you get any wise words along the way of encouragement or advice that you'd like to share with our students at home?
You know, keep your chin up. Everything's not going to be gravy all the time. You know, you always got to keep your chin up, and you got to keep it moving, because everything, never get too down, never get too high, because, you know, a lot of things don't go your way all the time. You just got to keep pushing, and you're the only one that can control your emotions. So I think that's the best advice I can give right now.
Thank you. Yeah. So all our students, keep working hard, push
keep
through
working.
It. All right. Well, again, this is David Ausberry, and I'm Toni Esther, and this has been an InBounds production with the Raiders.
You are now watching the throne. Don't let me get in my zone. Don't let me get in my zone. Don't let me get in my zone. These other niggas is lying, acting like the summer ain't mine.
I got that hot to my home.
You know how many hot bitches I own. Don't let me get in my zone. 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 The stars is in the building. They hands to the ceiling. I know I'm about to kill it. How you know I got that feeling? You are now watching the throne. Don't let me into my zone. Don't let me into my zone. I'm definitely in my zone.